It is incumbent upon all of us as Americans, regardless of race, region, faith, that we recognize this is an American problem and not just a black problem or a brown problem or a Native American problem. This is an American problem. When anybody in this country is not being treated equally under the law, that's a problem. And it's my job as president to help solve it.
As a new Congress prepares to settle in and get to work, our elected officials are facing a time of crisis in so many arenas and will need to truly lead the way in finding the answers Americans are demanding. Health care, immigration, terrorism, and now the racial tension gripping this nation has taken precedence. Let's welcome to Midpoint the junior United States Senator from Wyoming, member of the Committee on Foreign Relations, John Barrasso, joins us today. Senator, thank you so much for being here.
Ed, thank you for having me.
Senator, we are now at the beginning of what needs to be a very serious discussion on race, police relations, and much more in this country. Americans are looking not only to the president, but to their elected leaders, such as yourself and so many others, for leadership. Where does it need to start, in your opinion, to put this country back on a track where people trust their cops?
Well, you know, it is interesting as we look at this and what's been happening just the last couple of days, and specifically in New York, there are obviously lots of concerns out there. It continues the dialogue that we need to have, need to continue, and I think that we need to continue working toward agreements where community members talk to one another, know each other, where the police know the folks where they live and the beats in which they serve, and continue the discussion. But I think we need to get to a point where ultimately there is a return to trust in this country.
How do our lawmakers and such as yourself help get us to that point? Because what you're saying is true. Unfortunately, we've heard so much of it before, the fact that we need to have dialogue, we need to have trust, we need to get people talking. This has been around for a while, and we're still not there. Something is stopping us from getting to that point, and I'm curious from your perspective now what that is and how we can overcome that.
I think more dialogue, more opportunities to talk with one another in public, in private, in communities, in community centers, through our churches, through our charities. All of those things, all of those entities need to work together to work toward, a betterment of all of us in society.
Do we need to, in your opinion, get into the police departments across America, revamp them, rework them, do something there? Because I'll tell you that a lot of the people that I speak with, I have a lot of friends in law enforcement, and they're now very concerned that they will not be able to do their job, that there will be an overreach or an overreaction here to this and stop the honest cops, honest law enforcement, even Homeland Security from being able to do their job.
Well, I think that concern is legitimately out there. I heard it at home in Wyoming this past weekend, and we obviously are a very law-abiding and law-and-order state in the Rocky Mountain West. So clearly, we want to get to the point where our police officers are trusted, respected, looked up to, held as a position of prestige. And it's just a concern when situations arise that call that into question. And then on top of that, the amount of damage that is done and violence and destruction by those who respond in ways that hurt innocent people in return.
Speaking of that, with about a minute or so that we have left, then we'll break, come back, and talk about some other issues as well. But when we're talking about the citizens themselves, does there need to be a greater understanding of the responsibility of the citizens to follow the law, to not, I'm going to make this very clear, get in the face of officers? Because, and I'm not talking about the individuals here in these cases, but certainly there is that opinion now. There's that sense in America that they can go up against the cops, up against them, and they can basically get in their face. And that seems to be a big problem, whether you're white, black, green, blue, whatever.
Yeah, that level of behavior doesn't help anybody. It inflames the situation, but it's why I say the conversation needs to continue through our churches, through our communities, through our charities, people working together and talking through these things. Because, as you know, this happens very quickly, and within a matter of seconds, a situation can turn deadly.
Exactly. Well, Senator, please stand by for just one moment. We'll take a break here. Other side of the break, Senator John Barrasso returns. We're going to dig into the news of Al-Qaeda, now working the ISIS side of the terrorist street. Plus, we also talked a little bit about Obamacare. We talked about immigration. Also, there's the potential for a looming lawsuit over the president's executive action on immigration. And at 51 minutes after the hour, in Telling It Like It Is, similarities and stark differences in three recent police shootings. This begins part of the conversation. It's a conversation we intend to continue right here on Midpoint, where we question everything.